Hello everybody, and welcome back. This episode is going to cover all the differences in the difficulty modes between NG04 and NGB. Now by the difficulty, I mean the modes that are available in each game, for example, Normal, Hard, Very Hard, Master Ninja, and so on. Not really which of the two is more difficult, as that's going to be very subjective. A lot of people kind of always land on one side of it, you know, either they think NG04 is more difficult or NGB. They both have things that do make them more difficult, stuff that I've already mentioned in this series. You know, for example, in NG04, the enemies do more damage and they have more health, but the enemies in black have more moves and so on. It really just kind of depends on kind of your playstyle, I guess, which one is more difficult. But anyway, I'm not going to digress too much here, as there is a ton to get through in this episode. So, yeah, get comfortable. There's a lot to get through. So let's start out with the enemies and selectable difficulty modes. In NG04, there's just the three. You have Normal, Hard, and Very Hard. And in Ninja Gaiden Black, you actually have five, four of which are selectable, all of the above, and one easier mode, which is Ninja Dog, which is unlocked by dying and choosing to continue the game three times on normal difficulty, from the start of the game. There's also a high mode that will unlock after you beat Very Hard mode, which is called Master Ninja, which becomes available in Mission mode as well after you beat a mission on Very Hard. There is an astounding amount of differences between these two, and while I'm not going to cover every single little detail, as I'm sure there's probably one or two things I've probably missed, I'm going to cover as many as I can comfortably fit into this video and that I can remember while writing this. So let's kick off with perhaps the most evident change, and that's the enemy placements. In NG04, you will fight the same enemies on normal as you do on very hard, but in just greater numbers. Their aggression and AI will change slightly as you go up in the difficulties. Enemies that guard will do so more often, and enemies that dodge will do that a lot more too. The most notable difference in 04 enemy-wise, though, is in their level of aggression. They simply just do not let you breathe on the higher difficulties. You can see this in some of the other videos that's on the channel. I'll put up some clips here as well, but they just really are all over you all the time. You'll also see a difference in the projectile enemies. They're not only relentless, but they're extremely accurate and they hardly ever miss, in particular the archer enemies. And the limited camera control in NG04 does kind of act as a bit of an indirect buff towards these as well, because you can't really keep guys off screen like you can in NGB. There are some minor nerfs in Black, though, if you compare the same two modes. For instance, the Magma and Ice Fiends don't show up in the same places as they do in NG04, and due to their increased damage in 04, this makes Black a little easier in this regard. Where the differences really show, though, is when you start going above into the high difficulties in Black. Bosses will now be accompanied by minions above normal, and this really does change how you approach these encounters. Mirai, for instance, with Vigorian or Flame Ninjas, can put you down insanely quick, and having to focus on more than just the boss can be quite demanding at times. Compare this to 04, where the bosses don't have any minions except for Massacado and Marbus. They do deal insane amounts of damage, but the fight is still going to be one versus one, so you can just focus on the boss primarily. And if you're going up in difficulties, you're going to have fought them more than once by this point. In NGB, the minions also change throughout the difficulties. Generally speaking, they place the highest tiered enemy into the bosses for that group. For example, Mirai will go from White Ninjas to Flame Ninjas on Hard until Master Ninja. Enemy-wise, there really isn't a lot to cover in NG04, so I'm just going to list the most obvious changes that can be found in Black. Unless I state otherwise, it's safe to assume that the enemies in 04 are the same across all modes. As I go up in modes, I will outline any new additions. If something isn't mentioned, it's safe to assume it stays the same across the modes. This will just save me a bit of time, and you time as well, in going over things that don't need to be mentioned. So, for example, in hard mode, you'll notice a difference right away, as brown ninjas are replaced by white ninjas, and some white ninjas are replaced by the IS ninjas, or the black spider ninjas. Putting the black spider ninjas into chapter 1 really is a notable step up, and has always been the game's way of letting you know they're not messing around once you go above normal. Until chapter 4, it's mainly just more of the same enemies, and they're stronger with an extra fight. Chapter 4 is where you actually first encounter the armored commandos. These are similar to the non-armored ones, except they have a new attack and hit much, much harder. They're also immune to shurikens, unlike their unarmored counterpart, and you'll only be able to use the bow on them at this point in the game. This is also where cat fiends are first introduced, and I've always looked at these enemies as the jack-of-all-trades when it comes to abilities. They can both break and crush your guard, they can anti-air you very easily with the flying swallow, and they also have a grab. Fun fact, it actually is the one grab in the game that can be blocked, though. You can also intercept that in HP1. You come across the blue variation on hard, which is sort of a glass cannon type enemy, as they hit very, very hard, but they have extremely little health, so they're very, very easy to kill. Chapter 5 will give you more of these enemies, along with black spider ninjas, that have a noticeable increase in aggression. Hydra Cubus will have brown imps as his first tier of minion, He will have something far more deadly when you fight him again, though. Chapter 6 has the first new boss in the form of the Ryu clone wielding the Dragon Sword. His damage really isn't that bad on hard mode, but due to the reduced health bar, you still have to be quite careful against him. One Izuna drop is still going to put you in the ground at this point in the game. All of the imps in this chapter are replaced by blue cat fiends. This is a pretty significant buff again due to the new abilities they have. The fiend challenge can get out of hand very quickly, as two cat fiends constantly being able to anti-air you can keep you grounded more than you might like. It's also worth noting here that the cat fiend's flying swallow can triple connect on you if they hit you at the right angle in the air. So be very, very careful just kind of going into the air willy-nilly, because a triple connect flying swallow is well over half your health bar, even on hard at this point. Once you get into the underground, it's pretty much the same though. I've always wished they'd have changed this up a little bit. The zombies are still pretty easy, and while the archers are more accurate, they're no match for their NGO4 counterpart, and the inclusion of charged UTs, you know, really kind of breaks these encounters, as once you get rid of the archers, you can just, you know, print money on the rest of them. Some different imps here would have been pretty cool, or even some new enemy. You know, maybe they could have come up with like a magma fiend equivalent for the zombies. That would have been pretty cool, but sadly it's just zombies here. You just get a lot more of them on hard, and as the difficulties go up. The Bone Dragon has Wasp Fiends on every mode. Again, something I feel they could have increased on Very Hard and Master Ninja. Having said that, though, sometimes the camera can be a pain here, even with just the Wasps, so any normal enemy might have been a tad much. Chapter 7 mainly just increases enemy counts. The zombie challenge is always just zombies with increasing numbers. It's worth mentioning here that the rewards for the Fiend challenges do change across all difficulties. I won't go over them in this video, but you can find a full guide on this over on the forum, which I'll link below. A big change here as well is that the minions added to the rematch with Hydrocubus. Now he has cat fiends that come in waves of 3, but you get 2 and then 1. This is a huge buff for the boss in this fight due to the reliance on Ryu's own in-air moves to remove tentacles, and the cats are amazing at flying swallowing you out of the air. So if you get double flying swallowed here and land into one of Hydrocubus' grabs, that will actually kill you even with the max health bar. You know, that's just way too much damage for you to be able to handle at this point, because you're actually down a health upgrade that you would normally have here on hard compared to normal. I won't go over all the essence changes enemy-wise just in this video, but know that on the higher modes, all the tougher enemies will give a lot more money. There's also a full essence guide on the forum, which again is linked below, so feel free to check that out if you want. Before Alma, you're treated to some lovely ghost fish instead of bats. Get used to this change, as from here on in, it's pretty much this for the rest of the game. It's a harsh change, but the increase in essence rewarded, and you also get chances of Nimpo orbs from ghost fish, which you do not get in bats. You know, I think this balances it out quite nicely. More cats will follow before Alma, and she will have brown imps as minions, which is a pretty tame choice considering what follows in the higher modes. Chapter 8 is largely unchanged, except for the enemies having more health and doing more damage. The same is true for Chapter 9. The tanks and helicopters don't have minions with them, except in mission mode. The turntable fight does have a higher enemy count, but the armored soldiers, they don't show up yet. They won't pop up until very hard. You'll come across another clone in Chapter 10. This time he's armed with the Debilero. Enemy counts again go up, and the Peristyle Passage Fiend challenge remains pink imps only. You get a few ghostfish encounters thrown in place of bats. Pazu is the only boss here to have minions in the form of pink imps, and this is the first place where you come across the ogres as well in the fight before Pazu. Next up, you encounter the blue fish for the first time. These are kind of the same functionality-wise as the green fish. They just do more damage, and they also drop a lot more money. The encounters have more enemies than in normal mode, but Chapter 11 doesn't really throw any extra fights at you quite yet. That has to wait until very hard. Doku is accompanied by Silver Samurais. One example of where the highest tier enemy actually appears on hard, most likely due to Doku having ninjas on the modes after hard. Although in some ways I think a mixture of the two would have been better. You know, one samurai and one ninja, but sadly we don't get that. Chapter 12 brings some of the bigger changes that will stay for the rest of the game. Ogres are a lot more common here and take the place of fiends. Unfortunately, there aren't any magma or ice fiends like there were in NGO4. I still miss those even to this day. The staircase challenge is the same enemy-wise, but the stadium challenge is 80 ogres instead of fiends. We're treated to more ghostfish in place of bats, of course, and both Jotunfrau and Smorgon have enemies in their encounters. Jotunfrau has black cat fiends, which is their first introduction on hard. So they're a much stronger version of the blue cat fiends and give a lot more money. And Smorgon will have zombie archers here. And I'm only kind of thankful that they didn't do that in NGO4, because with no charged UTs and zombie archers with Smorgon, he would have been a pretty hard boss in that game. Moving on though, in Chapter 13, the enemies from 12 and 10 are the same in their respective areas. Again, this will be true for all modes. The Wasp challenge remains unchanged aside from enemy count, and the Great Bridge challenge now has ogres instead of the imps, which is quite a significant buff in terms of enemy type here. We also get another clone wielding the flails on hard. You'll fight him on the way to Awaken Nauma. I would still say it's a toss-up between this one and the UF clone for the most deadly of them all. Even on hard, one counter from the flail clone can kill you outright if you haven't got a lot of life upgrades. And Awaken Nauma will have pink imps again for minions instead of cats like Hydrocubus. Thankfully, they don't appear for Awaken Nauma in story mode. That's a mission mode only thing. No purple zombies yet in the tablet rooms, it's just the pill bugs with a higher enemy count as opposed to normal. On to Chapter 14, you will fight Commando Fiends instead of Pink Imps in the first fight, and the bats are still there beforehand. It's so weird how they weren't Ghostfish, as it seems to be a bit of a trend on the higher difficulties, but they are still bats. The rest of this chapter is pretty much the same as normal, except for Doku, which has Ghostfish as his minions, because the game just hates you, apparently. That was always a pretty funny thing to see people's reaction on the first time they got to go Spirit Doku with Ghostfish's minions was put the fear in a lot of people. The core is where you'll find most of the differences in Chapter 15, though. The first fight is Cat Fiends, which in some ways is a bit of a nerf. I think the Red Fiends and Cats would have been a tougher combination, and you only get blue ones in hard mode. They don't even give you the Black Cat Fiends. The next floor is Commandos and Laser Crabs, a combination that in NGO4 would genuinely be pretty terrifying due to how aggressive they are, and all their attacks are a lot faster in that game as well. Floor 4 is where you'll get Laser Crabs and Ogres combined, something that will be very common on the upcoming difficulties. The Marbus Gauntlet is totally overhauled here as well. You'll get Cats right off the bat instead of Imps. Both Hydrocubus and Jotunfrau have Crab Imps as their minions, which is the first introduction of them in hard mode. And bosses having the guard-breaking and guard-crushing minions becomes very common from here on out for the game. Marbus will summon blue cat fiends instead of pink imps as well. Emperor 1 has the biggest change when you go up in difficulty, in that her lasers move much faster on the higher modes. It's most noticeable, when looking at normal directly to Master Ninja, but if you go through all this fight on every mode, you'll just gradually see the lasers moving more quickly as you go up in the difficulties, and these can be pretty hard to dodge if you end up right next to them. They start moving extremely fast. Fiend Mirai doesn't have any minions with him in story mode on any difficulty, thankfully. That's another mission mode only thing. He does a lot more damage, and his Shuriken Volley will have more projectiles than on normal. This goes up in number as you go up in difficulty, similar to how Alma's projectiles will go up. You know, on normal, she'll have 4 fireballs. On Master Ninja, she'll have 12, and she'll have 2 and 6 pillars and that sort of thing. Anyway, that was a lot of information to kind of digest in one go, and hopefully you're still with me. To keep this video a little more interesting though, let's switch gears here a little bit and talk about something different. Let's talk about the Scarab changes, because these are also quite big across the modes. These change drastically depending on what difficulty you're playing on in NGB, but in NGO4 the rewards are actually the same across every mode. You also get less rewards from Muramasa for Scarabs in 04 compared to Black. You get 12 on Black, whereas you only get 6 in 04. 7 if you count the classic NG game that can be used at Hans Bar, but this doesn't really benefit you as an item in any way, so I don't really include it in those. Scarab locations are the same across every mode in both games as well. I'll put up a comparative list here so you can see all the rewards between the games. I have also included Hurricane Pack 1 as well. Feel free to pause right here if you want to see them all, but you can find a guide to these on the forum as well, which again is linked below. While on the subject of Scarabs, it also makes sense to cover the Muramasa differences as well. Items go up in price on both games, and are the same except for Master Ninja, where they get even more expensive. And on Ninja Dog, they're actually even a little bit cheaper than normal. I haven't forgotten about Ninja Dog here either, but the differences on that are quite minimal, so I'll leave that for last. The biggest change here, item-wise, between the two games is that on NGO4, you can actually hold the same amount of items across every difficulty, whereas in NGB, they reduce your max items once you go above hard mode. You can't hold more in Ninja Dog, but you do get extra healing items and Nimpo refills via the Ione's Kunai scrolls that pop up throughout the game. You'll also start out with a talisman on Ninja Dog for free and the Armlet of Potency equivalent. The Fiend Challenge rewards are also changed up in every mode in NGB, whereas in 04, they're the same on every fight in every difficulty. And last on the big item changes is that the Life of the Thousand Gods in Chapter 4 is no longer there in NGB on hard mode and above. And all the devil elixirs are removed from chests when you go above normal and are replaced by single Life of the Gods or usually small health elixirs, depending on what difficulty you're playing on. To save everyone's time, I'm not going to go over every item change in this video either, but there is a full item guide on the forum, which again is linked below. So that's a little bit of a housekeeping done, and that was a nice little detour away from all the enemy changes. Now I'm going to cover Very Hard and Master Ninja. Before I dive into this segment though, keep in mind, whatever I don't mention when talking about these two is more than likely the same. These two modes are very similar in terms of enemies and encounters, and it's mainly just numbers that are different. So, let's get through this so we can finish on something slightly more interesting. Chapter 1 introduces Vigorian ninjas on Very Hard and Flame ninjas on Master Ninja. You'll only come across Vigorian ninjas in two encounters on Master Ninja, and the rest are just a mix of Black Spider ninjas and Flame ninjas. I think it's a bit of a shame that the three ninja types aren't used more often, as having to fight all three at once really forces you to learn each of their unique weaknesses, but who knows, maybe someday this could be achieved via mods now that this game is playable via emulator. On to Chapter 2, and the Vigorian ninjas that replace the Black Spider ninjas are replaced by Flame ninjas at the beginning. There is also a bonus fight before the Firewheels Nimpo as of Very Hard. Enemy-wise, the rest of this chapter is the same on these modes. Master Ninja just has higher enemy counts. Chapter 3 introduces the laser copters on Very Hard after the Crank Room, which I'd say at least 50% of the people just got lasered right off when this first happened. I know I did. The rest of the fights are pretty much the same, just with more enemies. The armored soldiers would have been really cool here, I think, if they'd have showed up in this chapter. It's a shame you have to wait until Chapter 4 to see these guys. Speaking of Chapter 4, though, Chapters 4 and 5 are pretty much identical, except for some encounters having a blue cat fiend in them, which is replaced by either a ninja of either type on Master Ninja. Hydra Cubus has crab imps on Master Ninja instead of pink ones as well. And likewise for Chapters 6 and 7, crab imps will replace the pink imps on Master Ninja compared to Very Hard, and the zombie challenge is the same. Alma will have pink imps and crab imps for Very Hard and Master Ninja. I really think Alma should have had blue or black cat fiends here in these places, or a mixture of the two. The added danger of these two together would have been really, really cool. The hardest change, though, across these chapters is probably in the form of the Archive Challenge. The monks are replaced by Flame Ninjas, and if you don't fight this encounter, entirely on the ground floor, it's easily one of the toughest in the game. You can do it in Chapter 7 with the bigger health bar and the level 3 sword, but even just one triple Flying Swallow anti-air and you're dead here on Master Ninja. On Very Hard, it's just a simple blue and black cat fiend swap with a higher enemy count. Armored Soldiers are the biggest change to Chapter 8, along with an extra Berserker on Master Ninja. I always thought it was a bit odd that you didn't get them on Very Hard, as the regular ones really aren't much of a threat by this point in the game, and, again, you've played through the game twice now, so the Armored ones would have been kind of cool. Laser Helicopters will be present on the Military Gate as well before you go through that for the end of the chapter on both modes. And Chapter 9 is pretty much identical, except for the turntable fight having more enemies on Master Ninja compared to Very Hard. And now on to Chapter 10. The big difference here is easily the introduction of Laser Crab Fiends on Master Ninja mode. On Very Hard mode, you get Crab Imps along with Pink Imps, which is quite a bit easier, all things considered. And the Laser Crabs here do have a lot less health than later in the game, compared to, say, Chapter 15 on Master Ninja. And I'll take this opportunity to repeat this yet again, but explosive arrows are really, really, really good against Laser Crab Fiends. I cannot stress that enough. If you're struggling with these guys, I think it's two or three arrows. Take them out on Master Ninja at this point. So they're extremely good on them. A lovely friend, the Dabiliro clone, has explosive arrows, speaking of them, and is a damn sniper by anyone's standard. The first time everyone comes up against this guy, not knowing this, and you just get shot immediately, and it's not even funny. Unless, of course, you may have watched a friend get to that point and deliberately didn't tell him that he had the explosive arrows. But what kind of person would do that, Anyway, the rest of the chapter is pretty much the same. The fiend challenges are crab imps on both modes, and still Pillbugs and Pazu has crab imps. Pazu has crab imps, sorry, as his minions on both difficulties. I really wish the Peristyle Passage would have included some more, man-sized enemy encounters. I feel like that would have been a cool place to have a ninja and imp mix, as I don't think you actually get that mixture of enemies anywhere in the game. The crab imps are pretty boring after a while. Chapter 11 introduces the armored fish, which is the black ones, and these are just more, they just have more health and they're immune to the spear gun. They also give a lot more money though. These guys are worth 2 grand, even just, if you kill them normally. So you can really, really get a lot of money here quite easily. And there's a bonus fight after the medallions are placed on both modes here as well. And Doku will have black spider ninjas on very hard, and he'll have flame ninjas on master ninja. And moving swiftly on to Chapter 12, the biggest changes here are found in the Fiend Challenges. The Stadium Challenge on Very Hard is a mix of Ogres and Berserkers, whereas the Master Ninja version is just a solid 120 Berserkers and a snooze fest. I really wish they'd have flipped these over, or even mixed in some other enemies for Very Hard, as 100 Berserkers honestly would still be pretty boring. Berserkers and Ogres and or crab fiends, or berserkers and ninjas could have been cool. It's a bit of a slog to get through either of these fiend challenges, really. The Kitetsu clone can be fought in either this chapter or chapter 13, and he's introduced as of Very Hard. And the caverns have the same enemies in all their fights on both modes. They just have more health, on master ninja. And now we're making some progress. Chapter 13 has the above clone, if you want to fight him in this chapter instead. And other than that, the biggest change is again the Fiend Challenge in the Great Bridge. The very hard version of this is pretty easy by comparison. You get 60 ninjas, but you only get 3 at a time. And the rest are berserkers. I think it's 66 ninjas or 62 ninjas, and then the rest are berserkers. And again, I would have preferred a different mix here. On Master Ninja, you get laser crabs, ogres, and berserkers, which is a much more dynamic fight. And that sort of mix would have been really cool in the Stadium Challenge as well. Awakened Alma has crab imps as minions on both modes here. And you'll get a purple zombie alongside the Pillbug fights before the end of the chapter. And the only change in Chapter 14 is the addition of the UF clone on Master Ninja. On Very Hard, you still get commandos. The Lunar clone, I think, would have been really cool here for Very Hard, just to put him in story mode, as he's the only clone that's only in mission mode, unfortunately. And Spirit Doku still has Ghostfish for both modes. And Chapter 15 is very, very similar on Very Hard and Master Ninja until the Marble Gauntlet. I'll put up some just brief clips here of the core so you can see the floors here, as every floor is the same on these modes. And I'm getting a little bored of going over all these changes, so you're probably getting bored of listening to them. Nishay doesn't have minions on Very Hard compared to Master Ninja, which always struck me as a bit of a weird choice. And Ishtaros is included on Very Hard along with Nishay, but Ishtaros doesn't have minions on either mode. Marbus will summon crab imps on both modes here, and the emperors are the same with just more health. Chapter 16 is just Fiend Mirai again, but he will have an increased shuriken projectile count on Very Hard and Master Ninja, and that's about it. So that's it for all the difficulty changes. Anything that I didn't mention, going into Hard and Very Hard, going to Hard, Very Hard, Master Ninja, you can assume it's the same, so I'm not going to go over every single change with regards to each difficulty, as this video would probably be about 2 hours long. So the last thing to cover on this is the inclusion of Ninja Dog and successive play. So Ninja Dog plays the same as normal, enemy-wise, but with some reduced enemy numbers in some of the encounters. The Fiend Challenges are also all 40 enemies in Ninja Dog instead of 60, which does actually kind of mess with the scoring, but I'll cover that more in the next video. And you get access to the bands and the extra items throughout the game. The bands are pretty much just all of the armlet equivalents, but you get them a lot earlier. So you get Potency in Chapter 1, you get Celerity in Chapter 5, and you get Fortune in Chapter 8. And giving you those 3 armlets super early is actually a pretty huge buff throughout the whole game, really. It's especially Fortune. Like, Fortune and Celerity super early is really cool. On to successive play now, which is only in NGO4, and it's very disappointing. It's not a true New Game Plus mode, as it kind of implies. Instead, you just get to carry over your scarabs into the next run, and you can trade them at Muramasa in Chapter 2. You'll get all the items that they would normally give you, except the Dabilaro, which is the thing you'd want. It's really annoying. You can still get this in Chapter 8 again by talking to Muramasa, and he'll give you the Dabiliro, even though you don't have any more scarabs to give him. It's a real shame that this wasn't in there. A true New Game Plus would have been cooler, but you know, the Dabiliro early on would have been a lot of fun to be able to have that. But thankfully, you know, now that we have mods and that, it's actually pretty easy to get New Game Plus and that setup. I'll link Guilty's channel again below for that if anyone's interested in checking out some mods for the game. And that's it. This was a long one compared to the others, but it was a topic that I knew would be a tag and boring, so I figured I'd get it out of the way. This was a very info-heavy episode, so hopefully this was easy to digest. I tried to keep the clips as short as possible, but without, you know, kind of overdoing it and showing stuff that I'd already shown. And hopefully this video didn't send anybody to sleep. But that's it for this one, guys. I was hopefully this covers all the big things. If you had any questions about the difficulties, any others that I might not have covered or you missed, just let me know below and I will answer them. And we'll get on to something a little bit more interesting in the next video. So I hope you enjoyed this one, guys, and I will catch you next time. Thanks for watching. Peace.